So as we're looking in Hebrews chapter 12, and today our theme is really verses 1 and 2, where the writer there says, seeing that we're compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses, let us run the race with patience, the race that is set before us. And he says that we are to throw off the weight, to get rid of the weights. And we talked about this maybe a couple weeks ago, of how runners oftentimes, when they are getting ready to do a long distance race, in training, they would wear weights around their ankles or around their body. Sometimes wrestlers do this as well. But when they get ready to do the race, the actual event, they lay those aside. They get rid of them so that they can run the race without the extra weight. And so as we think about that today, we think about the weights that we may carry in our lives and weights that may be a hindrance to us. In the book, Don't Give Up, Kyle Ottoman, he talks about some things in the next few weeks. If you're reading the book, he brings out some things that, in addition to what maybe we're talking about today, but we want to look at that today, at some of the things that may be a weight. Now, I'm not a marathon runner. You probably know that by now, but I do run a little bit, but most of my long distance travel is hiking, backpacking. And in backpacking, when you're doing a long distance haul, you have to carry everything for the however long you're going to be out there. So if you're out there for a week or a weekend or a night, when I do backcountry camping, I don't go to a campsite. I go in the mountains. And now Sandy and her family, once a year, they go to Cave Run, and they have a campsite, a group campsite that they use. And it has bathrooms with hot showers and all that, and a picnic area. That's not the way I camp. To me, that's not primitive, rugged camping. It's great, but it's not what I'm talking about. Because the kind of camping that I do, you can't take all the comforts of home with you because you have to carry it all on your back. And I was reading an article I want to share. It's by Preston Kahn. And he talked about 10 things that he would do differently if he were to hike the Appalachian Trail again. So on his hike on the Appalachian Trail, he learned some lessons. But one of those I want to share with you today is this. And this was an article in the Roads and Rivers and Trails magazine. He said to remember this, you aren't camping, you are long distance backpacking. Now, when you walk the Appalachian Trail from Georgia to Maine, it takes an average of about 6 months to do a through hike. A through hike is where you start and you don't stop till you get finished. Some people do section hikes, so they may do a week or a few days at a time. But a through hiker understands that it's not about camping. You may rest your head at night at a place such as a backpack shelter or in a tent, but it's not about the camping, it's about the hiking. So remember that you aren't camping, you're long distance backpacking. This is some things he said. One of the sacrifices you're going to have to make when doing this beast of a trail is giving up some of the comforts of your everyday life and some of the comforts you may have grown accustomed to when you are going out for a fun weekend trip. So I know that when we go on a camping trip, in a family camping trip, that we take everything but the kitchen sink. And sometimes we may even take the kitchen sink. And I mean, everything you can imagine. But this is not the kind of thing he's talking about. He says this, nice things that make you feel good have a weight attached to them. And when you start compounding those nice things, you start to have a pack that is far too heavy. Now, he didn't write this for a sermon, but I think it fits perfectly for what we're talking about today. Too much weight will hold you back. And I like this. He said, out on the trail, the heavier your pack, the less likely that you are to complete the whole thing. So people that try to take too much, well, they're probably not going to be able to complete the trail. And so to want to talk about some things that may be weights, and it may be different for you than me, what your weight is. First of all, he talks about the sin that besets us or keeps coming back up. Those sins that are a problem and a constant thing, try to lay those aside. Kai Ottoman talks about in his book the idea of casting off, the throwing off the weight. It's not like throwing it away, but it's the idea of transferring it. And you transfer that weight to somebody else, which is God. Casting all your cares up on Him, for He cares for you. Not the idea of throwing it, but saying, here, you take and distribute this weight. And so sometimes on long distance trails, I've had like my sons with me before, and when they were younger, they'd have a little backpack, but they couldn't carry all the things they needed to carry, and it would get too heavy for them. So I would take most of that weight and put it in my backpack, and I carried most of the weight, and then they still felt like they were carrying something. And the same thing is true in the Christian life. We carry much more weight than we should sometimes. We need to give it to God. So let's talk about some weights that we may carry. And the first one is anxiety or fear. And I brought my backpack with me today. I'm sorry, Andy, for the camera guy, for making you move around so much. But I brought my backpack with me. This is what I've used on many miles on the Pine Mountain Trail and other trails that we've hiked. But it's a little rugged, but it does a trick. But in this backpack, I have to take everything I'm going to need for my trip. So some things you've got to have are essential. Of course, water. You can't take all the water that you're going to have, so you'll usually take maybe a water filter. So I've drank from creeks, streams, and even mud holes if I've had to. But I filter those, so no matter if it looks clean or what, I filter it. So a filter, food and all that, those are things that you have to take. So let's look at some things that people may take on backpack trips that aren't necessary, and they just add more weight. On the Appalachian Trail, one of the first stops you get to is actually a dumping station where you take all the stuff you don't need and you dump it. So you may have people realize after hiking 20 miles or 30 miles, man, I didn't need that, and so I'm getting rid of this. So half the stuff that we take, they end up getting rid of and sending it back home or trading it. So here's one of the things you probably won't need on a long distance backpacking trip, and that is a hairdryer. Now, I know that you may think, well, I got to blow dry my hair. But trust me, women and men who've hiked the Appalachian Trail and long distance trails realize that there's some comforts of home that we just can't have. And you're going to be out there and you're going to be sweating, you're going to be getting dirty, you're going to be not being able to do showers every day. So a hairdryer is not needed. So let this hairdryer represent anxiety today. We'll let it represent anxiety and fear. So what we want to do is to transfer that and simply give it to Jesus. We're just going to give it to the Lord today. So we'll put that back there and let God pick our anxieties. And we know today that a lot of people are experiencing anxieties and fears on every hand, especially with the pandemic. And for some people, it's gotten better, and maybe some it's gotten worse, but there's anxieties and fears that take us all into different directions and make us feel frustrated and things. So in his book, Max Lucado wrote a book called Anxious for Nothing. He gives us a prescription for anxiety that spells out an acrostic for the word calm. And it is to celebrate, to ask, to leave, and to meditate. And here's what he says. First of all, in verse 4, Philippians says, rejoice in Philippians 4, I believe, rejoice in the Lord always. So celebrate God's goodness. If we celebrate God's goodness, and if we're spending time, and even Kyle Ottoman talks about the fact that if we're thankful, we will help do away with a lot of the anxiety that we have. And he talked about the fact that sometimes we give our anxieties to God, but sometimes we need to give let our anxieties know about God, and that we have a God, and we, you know, kind of like in the psalm where he begins to talk about, "Be still, O my soul," and we, you know, talk about some of these things. Now, he also mentioned, I appreciated this, the fact that some people have things that are physically wrong, and maybe a chemical imbalance, and so we're not really talking about that, but we're talking about unneeded anxiety sometimes that we bring on ourselves. Verse 6 says, in everything by prayer and petition. So ask for God's help. That's the A, that we need to ask for God's help. Sometimes we don't. The Bible says we have not because we ask not. And so we need to ask God for his help today. And sometimes it's just a matter of humbling ourselves and saying, "Lord, I need your help." The third one, the L, is to leave your concerns with him. With thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. So give God your cares. Leave your concerns with him. And then number 4, meditate on good things. And he says, think about these things, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are lovely, positive, if there be any good things in them, think on these things. And so these will help us to be calm and to get a meditative state and find a way to be calm. So that can help us with our anxiety. So transfer it, give it to God. Now the next one I think is one that we deal with sometimes, and that's pride. Pride is something that, as I just mentioned, it keeps us from coming to God. He talks about humbling ourselves and casting our care on him. I think they go hand in hand. If we humble ourselves, we're going to call on God. Sometimes we think that we don't need help. And so humbling ourselves may mean asking somebody for help, or it may mean asking God for help. It's important for us to realize sometimes that we need help, and it's okay. It's okay. You know, I as a chaplain at the hospital, you know, this is a different time for us all right now. And you understand that we have people that they do testing for this COVID-19, and they're in the hospital, and they have not they've been tested, but the test hasn't come back yet. So I don't go to those floors, but I talk to people through by way of telephone or FaceTime. And one of the individuals I was able to talk to when I called up, I've had a really good response, and I asked him, "What would you like to pray about today?" He wanted prayer. This is what he said. He said, "Pray for my soul." And I thought that was interesting. That his main concern was not, he didn't say anything about pray for my health or pray that I don't have the virus. Pray for my soul. He said, I've wandered away from God and I want to get back with God. And I thought that was a great thing. You know, that we understand that our praying about our soul and our spiritual conditions is just as important, actually more important than our physical condition. But pride keeps people from doing that sometimes. Sometimes pride is what keeps us from doing that. Again, 1 Peter 5 says, "Humble yourselves, therefore, under God's mighty hand, that he may lift you up in due time." And so we'll look at this here as another thing that people do. This is food, okay? You got to have food when you go on a hiking trip. But if you're going on a long-distance trip, this is spinach, which I love, you don't want to take big, heavy cans of food, because if you do, it will weigh you down. The more you do, and trust me, if you walk 10, 20 miles with this kind of weight, you are going to be really tuckered out. It's not going to work too well. So what happens is most cross-country hikers will take dehydrated food and add water later on the trail, and it's much lighter on the load. So you can't take food. So let's let this represent pride today. And to say that a lot of people carry around a lot of weight simply because they're too proud to take their pride and to give it to God. So let's give that to God today. The pride that keeps us from admitting when we're wrong, admitting that we're helpless sometimes, and admitting that we need God and we need someone else. So pride is the other one. And then the next one is unforgiveness. The weight of unforgiveness. And, you know, sometimes that means not forgiving myself, or it may be not forgiving someone else. And what I have for that today is a pillow. Now, a pillow is something we all love at home. But when you're across country camping, you may have to do without your pillow, at least this kind of pillow. Now, I have an inflatable pillow that I do take sometimes, and I can blow that up. But this is much too heavy and takes up way too much space in my backpack. It's a comfort, but let this one also represent unforgiveness. We need to get rid of that one because it is holding us back and keeping us from running the race that God has for us. And I tell you, sometimes even as Christians, we get things on our mind, or somebody may get something against us, but it's a hindrance to our Christian life. When we can't let those things go, whether it's a relationship with a spouse or someone else, when we can't let it go and we can't offer forgiveness, then it burdens us down. It really is a weight in the Christian life. And we've got to be careful that we're not carrying around unneeded weight, such as unforgiveness today. And so those are just some things, and you may have some more really hold you back or keep you from running the race in the Christian life. And so if you get rid of that weight and you give it to God, then you'll be able to go much further, much faster, and be much stronger than you would if you carried around all this needless weight. Now, what's your weight? It may not be any of these things. It may be something else. It may be anger. And the Bible, you know, gives a whole list of things that we shouldn't do. It talks about sins of the flesh and different things that may be a problem in the Christian life. And he said, these things should not be characterized of you. It should not be something that you as a Christian should carry around. So let us run the race with patience, the race that is set before us, or walk the miles that is set before us, but get rid of the weight. What is holding us back today? What is it that's keeping you from being what you need to be for God? That's holding you down, whether it be anxiety, whether it be pride, whether it be unforgiveness, or many other things that may be in your way today. What is the thing that's keeping you from being what you need to be for God today? I'm going to ask you today to give that to God. I want to ask the musicians to come back up as we pray. We're going to get ready to celebrate communion in just a minute, but we're going to sing. Before we do, I want to pray for you. And I've asked you this last week, but I want to ask you to do the same thing this week. I want to ask you to pray this prayer with me. Whoever you are, I want you to pray this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, be merciful to me, a sinner. Amen. And if you prayed that prayer, I want you to know that God honored your prayer. And He loves you and He forgives you. And I just want you to trust in Christ and live your life for Him. Amen.